Hi everybody. Going to throw a bowl. This is about 1.5 pounds or so. Maybe a little over that. I'm going to throw a bowl and I'm going to use this. I've just got this out of the bisque fire and I waxed it. It's been sitting for a couple of days. A couple of coats of wax on it. So I'm going to be using this when I get the bowl opened. So just basically to show how it works, because that's the one, remember I told you about having made another one before, and that it was my favorite rib for bowls, and I took it to school and I was showing the kids how to use it. And somebody said at about the same time, he said, "Will it break?" And he wrapped it on the side of the table at about the same time he said that. And of course it broke. So yeah, I was really sad because it was my favorite rib. Kids are kind of unpredictable sometimes. Okay, let's see here. I'm throwing reclaim. And let's see how deep that is. And it's kind of soft because it hasn't been sitting very long, actually. But it's pretty smooth. Really, this video is as much for me as it is for you, because I made this rib, this S-curve rib, a little bit thicker than I made the other one, so that it would withstand a little bit of abuse anyway. So I think though from now on I'm going to have the kids just use wooden or metal ribs, or make their own. Maybe a good lesson would be for them to make their own pottery ribs, clay ribs, if they want one like that. But I brought all my clay ribs home because I have a round one that I made at the same time and I really like it and I don't want anything to happen to it. But anyway, easy come, easy go, right? It's what you get with kids. Okay, I think I have that fairly well compressed in there. So let's... won't be a very big bowl because it's only a pound and a half, and this is all that I have wedged right now. I'm gonna have to get busy and do some stuff around here that is called maintenance. Studio maintenance. And I've either got a bubble or something in there that I can feel. Let me stop it and see if I can find it. Feel like a string or something. Okay. Not gonna be upset about a string. Whoa. Thank you. Okay, where was I? Oh yeah, let's throw this wall. Okay, so on a bowl, let's see, I'm not going to get right up against it, but I am going to clean up the bottom of it just a little bit. Well, I said I wasn't going to get up against it, but I guess I kind of did. Okay. So I've got a nice cylinder. Maybe I should rib the side of it, just for the outside of it, just for kicks. And sometimes I'll do a sponge on the inside just to even up the wall. Let go a little bit when you get up close to the top. And now let's see if that S-curve rib is any good. So I'm going to dampen the inside and the outside, but I'm going to especially dampen the inside. This thing is new. I'm going to slow my wheel down, but my rib is kind of new, so I'm going to put in the water just to get it all wet. And let's slow her down. I don't know how. So I'm going to put this right down into the bottom. You got to take it by both hands. And you're going to tilt it. When you let go, you got to let go really slow, because you don't want to jerk it out of shape. Let's see, let me get the clay off of it. Okay. So I'm on the bottom, and I'm over to one side, and I'm leaning it, and I'm going to tilt it to one direction just a little bit too. So there is a beautiful bowl. The inside of it is smooth as it can be, except for that piece of glob I just put in there. Didn't mean to do that. See if I can get that out of there. So really, you know, if you basically have the same number of pounds, and on this one, I'm just kind of sliding it up. But this end gives me something to hang on to up here, and this gives me something to hang on to here. And then that leaves this entire curve available for, you know, being used as, or being up against the clay. Being engaged, I guess, would be a good word. So, and I messed up, tried to... I need to get that piece of clay out of there without distorting. There we go. Okay. So if you have any little goobers to clean up, of course you can use a regular rib to further compress the clay. And it's beautiful. So you've got a way with a custom, or with any rib that's of any size like that, you've got a way of making consistent bowls and making the curve on the bowl very consistent. So no matter what size the bowl is, your curve can be the same every time. Let's see. Let me get this thing wet here. There we go. Hang on just a minute and I'll let you see the inside. Okay, so now this part gets trimmed later because, and I left enough for a nice nice foot. Yeah, I don't think there's enough to do a pedestal foot, but that doesn't matter. This is just a utility bowl. Okay, so let's look at the inside. I hope you can tell that it's how smooth it is. I've got about 3.5 pounds of clay here. And it's fairly stiff. Let's see. I have a loose bat, so that knocking sound that you hear, that's what that is. It's got a little bit of play in one of the holes. See how thick the bottom is. Not bad, that might be good. So let's compress the bottom. Okay, so let's slow it down. We're gonna start getting some shape on it. Okay. So let's see how that big old S-curve thing is going to work on this. Let's get it wet on both inside and out. Now, on a larger bowl, you don't just start down in the bottom. On a larger bowl, you start at the top inside edge and you start expanding it like that. This may not be long enough. So you start pulling the wall out. I don't think that's gonna, let me stop it and see. Yep, this might do it. It's gonna be close, because the top edge is gonna be right up there in the armpit of this thing. So let's see how far we can get with it. Okay. Alrighty. I'm going to try to lay this down a little more. Okay. Well, it made a nice flower pot, didn't it? I don't know if I'm going to be able to do a bowl out of it. I may have gotten the walls too thin. Let me switch to this one. This is the Dirty Girls rib, and I've used this in a video before, but the top part of this curve doesn't start for a long way. This one's considerably longer. So let's see if I can That's going to be a bowl. So after this is trimmed down here, I may not be able to pull the walls down very much further, because I'm less than about a quarter of an inch on the thickness. And I think that I've got quite a bit of clay right here that I can trim. and kind of round that off at the bottom to make a decent looking bowl. So I'm gonna do one more pull on the lay down and see if I can get that any. Okay. A new red clay for me. Let me get some light on this too, so that you can see it better. So there's the inside, but look how thin the edge is. I'm almost afraid that that's gonna break off. We'll see. We'll go ahead and finish it out and see how it works out. Sometimes if you flood that with water, you avoid having all this stuff stick to your bowl or whatever it is. That is beautiful. It's going to be beautiful when it's all trimmed up. I can't wait to see that. You know, I probably could have, let's see. Well, I don't know, may not. I think I'm going to have a narrow, it's definitely going to be a V shape. Wonder if I can get more of a curve in there. But let's see, I'm going to have more of a curve when I get that trimmed. Maybe I can put a little more of a curve. Do you ever do this? Get something, whoops, where it's totally acceptable the way it is. And then you go, I gotta push it just a little bit more. Well, let's see if we can push this just a little bit more. I don't think I actually pushed it out anymore. All right. I know, I can hear you all saying, quit now, quit now. It's only clay. If you screw it up, you can wad it up and re-wedge it and do it again. Okay, now I'm really gonna quit. All right, we'll trim it in the next day or so when it gets hard enough to do that with. Yeah, I hope we can trim it. Okay, thanks for watching.